The boy said I was capping. I showed that bitch, the boy got the whole line. ain't no goddamn way, boy. Ain't no fucking way. I told the boy, dog, Coach to behave, man. Coach just be talking shit to my boy, now. Nah. That's why we try to tell the nigga, I'm like, man, y'all boys can't be on this bitch taking that shit Coach be saying shit. Yeah, should we just have fun with this shit, man?
Real, for real.
Yeah, too much. Hey, damn, what the key is to? Oh, they in the car. I gotta go get the blue one. Matter of fact, oh, they doing the talk right now.
You calling me right now, Mama? Again.
I haven't seen the niggas in the comment. Somebody said I had to show the niggas in the comment. Man, this shit real, man. Boy, thought I was lying. They thought I should have bet $200,000 on a dunk. Shit, not Corey. Corey ain't spent $200,000 on a motherfucker dunk. You lost your rabbit ass mind. Ain't no fucking way. Ain't no way. Before I spend $200,000 on don't, I take my money and go buy that bitch. I mean, go build me one, shit. And I ain't gonna spend that much in that motherfucker, neither. You spend $200,000 on don't, you crazy.
Bitch.
Shit. I got them made $200 in one day. They can't tell me shit. I feel lovely today. you know what? I really tripping. I need to be at my season with a goddamn with a cup, nigga, with some alcohol in that motherfucker celebrate. That's what I really need to be doing for real, for real. I need to be goddamn somewhere celebrate right now, boy. The boy done made $200,000 in one day. Man, boys, they seeing me right now, man. He said, meet me on West Side. Let's do a light to light right quick. Hey, what you want me to drive, bro? I'm gonna drive the goddamn ZL1. Fuck the bullshit. My blue box, they got my blue box, my tie flat. I gotta goddamn put my new tie on that motherfucker. Fuck that bullshit. Ain't no way. That boy said, I'll call you back, mom. Yeah, hey, man.
Trying to come on for
serious.
I don't know
what I'm trying to tell y'all, boy. You know what I'm gonna do, though? I'm gonna stop playing, bro. I'm gonna stop playing, man. And just go ahead and goddamn and put me a big boy mold in my shit. And I wanna do something. I wanna do something. Cause this shit fun, you see what I'm saying? This shit fun. Yeah, $200,000 is the most I ever made in one day. I still can't believe this shit. Like, that shit crazy, bro. Bro, that shit crazy. This shit real. I'm still looking at this shit. This shit can't be real. This shit can't be real, bro. $219,000 in one day. One day, bro. And y'all see it. How much I make on a day. How much I make every day. Every day. You know what I'm saying? Go every day. Man, that bitch say $219,000 in one day. Man, can't tell me shit, man. Man, nigga, 23 years old and just made $23 million in one day. That's the most I ever made. But you know what I want to do, though? I feel like I want to goddamn I just want to do something cool and just go crazy on them niggas. I want to just do some shit, nigga, just drop the nigga mouth. Niggas just drop their mouth, niggas just be like, I hate the young nigga. I hate the young nigga. Like, because I can do it. Like, real talk, I can do it. Like, niggas, no, I'm telling niggas, like, nigga, I really can do whatever y'all are telling me to do, bro. Florida boy brag about $250,000 don't, but you just made $220 in a day. We two different lanes, man. We in two different lanes, bro. But got to respect the dump game, though. It's all fun, man. It's love. This shit fun and fuck. I ain't gonna lie. But fuck that, man. I'm trying to goddamn create generational wealth. I ain't signing that shit. I ain't gonna put all my money in these damn cars right now, man. I can go buy a $50,000-$60,000 motor right now. Slap that bitch in my dunk if I want to. Rick, goddamn not. Shit, if I really want to, I can just slap the dunk, the motor out the Camaro and slap that bitch in that motherfucker if I want to. But it's like, you know what I'm saying? It ain't that serious to me, bro. I want to just get in my car, ride, be clean. Fuck that shit. I'm letting the floor nigga talk this shit. Y'all keep putting all y'all money in the car y'all want to. My son gonna be riding past y'all, boy, fuck one day. Hey, the nigga gonna be looking at my son. They're gonna be like, God damn, little nigga balling and shit. I'm trying to create generational wealth, man. Fuck that.
Me?
Yeah, for my kids, boy. Fuck the bullshit. They can have them motherfucking motors. Long my shit ride, boy. I'm happy as a bitch. I just wanna get that motherfucking ride. They told me that Chevelle was a limit just then. That Chevelle got a 572 in now. Long that bitch ride to me, boy. I'm clean. I had people coming out and taking pictures of that bitch and everything. I see you, boy. That shit, somebody said, who you got to prove it to? Shit, you right. For real, man. That shit crazy. Man, tell you why the fuck Coke got online, man? I was just getting started, shit. Them Florida niggas think a nigga be capping. I'm trying to tell y'all niggas, now I'm a whole different type of nigga, boy. Them niggas in the comment talk, I was like, he capping. Them overgrown ass, them grown ass niggas. Only youngest in charge, nigga. Y'all niggas gotta sell that shit, boy. I stepped next to you, boy. You gotta bow down, boy, because I'm the youngest in charge, boy. You can't compete with me now. That's what I tell nigga. But you can't compete with me now. I don't give a fuck what's in your yard. You can't compete with me now. Shin me. I'm telling my boy Colt, and them boys, yeah, you gotta let them boys know, man. Respect the pimping, man. But goddamn. Nah, I think I'm still gonna do something crazy. I think I'm gonna have to go ahead and just. But I can't do nothing too crazy. They ain't already did, though. You see what I'm saying? Niggas did that shit already. He said, man, fuck no, just wait and put a motor in there. Yeah, I'm just chilling, man. I'm just chilling. The pull-up boy don't like with a nigga money longer than that. Hey. Shit, everybody said don't mess the link up. I need to go, nah. I don't want that racist shit in my car though. Ain't no way in here. Somebody said, dude said you got robbed.
It's morning time over here.
Somebody said, man, just drop an LT porn in the Chevelle and a dunk and shit on their ass. That's what I should do, huh? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna just get on here and order me some shit. I'd rather give me a crate burner, though.
You still got Jason?
Yeah.
Bro, you got the cars, bill first, then establish more. Bro, you got the cars, bill first, then establish more. Yeah, for sure. Man, I need to be dropping off a video. I ain't editing no video in a minute. I got like 2 videos. They're T-Po on the 15,000. Yeah, that shit cheap as shit, huh? That cheap ass got that motor?
Your car
man.
So good.
$15,000 yesterday. I made $15,000 for today. And it wasn't even the same. It was for yesterday. So yesterday I made $15,000 for today before today even started. I tell you what. You said that'd be 15 bands. Look what I just made today. Again. Yeah. Right now, for tomorrow right here. I just made $30,000 already. Today. That bitch say today. I just made 30 bands. I can go buy 2 of them bitches right now. Put one in the Chevelle, put one in the Dunk, and we cool. I can go buy that bitch right now. I just made that shit already. I can buy that shit, man. That shit. Yes, sir, man. That shit. I'm gonna buy me a little $15 motor, man. 2 of them bitches. I just made that shit today. Pop your shit, twin. Oh, cap. You hear me?
We should chill.
Yeah, I know. They know what it is, man. I gotta get the other dog. I ain't got it yet. I ain't even got that bit yet, man. Fuck that shit. We gonna go get that motherfucker. Lance said he said that they doing a trunk in that motherfucker right now. So, but yeah. I don't know, man. Them boy keep talking about that motor shit, man. But then again, like, I don't, you know, if I go over there, goddamn, and I buy me a motor, I put a motor in my shit, what gonna change? Now I got a fast damn motor, it's still bought a motor, them niggas. So, they better start, they don't want me to do that. Y'all better have, listen, I'm trying to get these niggas a little upper hand on top of me, man, so I can make my boys feel good now. Yeah, that bitch got money, but he ain't got no motor. Now, you know what? We gonna get the goddamn motor and have the money. Now, goddamn, they gonna be able to compete with me. Shit. I gotta get a nigga a little snack or something, goddamn, bro. Like, listen, bro, I'm gonna let y'all say y'all can do that. For real, for real. Oh, shit. Think about stupid as hell, man. Somebody just tune the motor you got now and put a power at them. I'm gonna take that bitch back to whoever put that motor in that car and let them tune that bitch, man. They ain't been tuned yet. So shit, you know. Whenever that bitch down, I'm gonna get that bitch. they trying to peer pressure you into buying something. We know you. We know you will. Yeah, man. I don't be having time for that shit though. For to be real with y'all, man. Like I just don't be stunning shit, man. I don't be stunning that shit for real. I just like to have fun. I just like to talk shit with my boy, man. I don't be stunning shit for real, bro. Because there ain't no purpose. Only nigga would be mad at that is a hater. The top dogs in Florida with don'ts ain't haters. For sure. Facts. Big facts. Cause everybody know this shit all fun and love, man. You know what I'm saying? Nobody take this shit serious. You take this shit serious, man, y'all tripping. Fuck all that. You gotta get all your cars in your yard. Ain't no way. Somebody said add your fans, your bougie ass. Ain't nobody bougie. The fuck?
I'm bored. I'm ready to get.
You wet, what?
I'm
bored. I'm ready to get. I know, man. Bro, this shit here crazy, though. I'm really lit, though, man. I'm excited as hell, bro. 2 months in a year, I done made 300 bands. I'm going for 30 million this year. That's my goal. That's my goddamn goal. Fuck that. We got 2 complete different goals. I know I love the car game and shit, but a fast motor in my car ain't gonna make me 30 million. My goal this year, I'm trying to make $30 million this year, man. That's exactly what the fuck I'm trying to do. And goddamn, I'm not bullshitting, bro. I'm going hard. I'm telling you, I'm going crazy. I want to make 30 million, bro. 30 million this year. You feel me? And you know, then I might just say, man, I'm gonna kick my legs. I'm like, man, hey, put me a motherfucking bit more in that car. I can afford it now. I can afford it right now. I can afford that shit right now, man. Fuck that shit, man. I'm broke, man. I ain't got no motherfucking 30 million in my bank account. I need 30 million. Fuck that shit. I am broke. You feel what I'm saying? Fuck that. No, I said 30 million by 30. But I got around a motherfucking billionaire. He opened my eyes up. And I said, fuck that shit. I need 30 million this year. 2022, I need 30 million. That's the goal. You see what I'm saying? Real shit. I can't chill, man. I'm broke right now. I made $200,000. I'm still broke. On everything, nigga. I made 200,000. Well, how much I made? 219,000. I'm still broke. And they ain't got nothing to do with all that money. I'm still broke. You know what's so funny, bro? I showed 200. Damn, that shit crazy. Never mind. That shit just crazy as fuck. I'm broke.
They always doing it.
Somebody said stop spending money. I'm broke, bro. Fuck that shit. Oh my God, what? Oh my God. Somebody said I'm saying I'm real. Well, since I ain't real, let me block you real quick. I don't really shit. I just blocked. They just got blocked. No, they feeling hurt. And it was a big fan, too. None of my lies on no crazy shit. And I just blocked the shit out there. Now they feel another lie. Why you blocked me? I ain't even lying. Shut your bitch ass up while they goddamn crying, motherfucker. Y'all that goddamn crying? You said I ain't real. So I just got your ass back. Got their ass back. What they talking about?
I got
this
house.
I see it. They tripping.
Well, I crashed in like a house.
All right, bro. Yeah, nigga tripping. Nigga tripping hard.
Again?
Pushing pee for real. Bought the hell out of there and I ain't gone. I'm going to say you got prop money. No, that's what we got to tell them. We got prop money, man. I'm broke. I need 30 million. What the fuck wrong with my damn computer? That be telling me to access certain parts of your dashboard. Oh, shit. All right, y'all. So, yesterday I made... All right, so I'm going to show y'all something right there. We're going to go live later on tonight, right? It's 6 o'clock. It's 6 o'clock here. Wherever this shit is, it's 12 o'clock in the morning. So now it is considered the next day. So the day is the day is the what? The second here. It is officially the third. Where my system at right here, okay? So I'm gonna show y'all. So look, check this out. It's a 12:01 a.m. 2001, I made $0. So it just started over. So yesterday I made 30 million. Damn, I said 30 million, shit. But I'm telling you, boy, I'm speaking that shit into existence, boy. Hey, listen, boy. I'm spinning that shit, boy. I'm speaking that shit into existence, boy. I don't care, but I made 30,000. I made 30,000, all right? See, this shit, that's what I'm trying to tell you, the time is different. So that's why I be saying certain days, but technically, you know? Paid. 219,000 paid. We lit. Ain't no way. That bitch done, huh? For sure. For shit, so. You know what I'm saying? For shit, bro. That bitch there. Yeah, man. One goddamn day, man. I want this bitch to say 500 next. I need to go for half a million in one day. Fuck the shit, man. I ain't gonna stop till I make half a million in one goddamn day, nigga. I ain't gonna stop there either. Don't keep going, but goddamn it, nigga, we go.
We thugging tonight,
boy. We gonna go to goddamn get us a drink. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, we gonna go celebrate. Your daddy just met another one of his goals, boy.
Again?
Again, boy. We gonna say again and again and again. Your daddy made $100,000 a month. We were doing that for a while. I made $200,000 a month. We did that, but yes. Then we did not. We just made $200,000 in one day, boy. One day, boy.
You made money.
Yeah, man. One day, man.
I can't believe that.
Yeah, you can believe that. For sure. For shit, so.
I can't believe it.
For shit, so. Man, come on, now. I gotta keep this nigga motivated, man. I want him to have that same. And I swear to God, like, the man just came here. They been to clean my pool. We went and dropped out my box shit to get it ceramic coated. And somebody else, everybody that come around this boy, he be talking to him, and they come at him and they say, Corey, that little boy is smart as hell. And it make me feel good as hell, you see what I'm saying? Make me feel good as a motherfucker. It's like, that's my goal, bro. I want my boy to be smart as hell. And you know what I'm saying? And I want him to be able to, when he grow up, I want him to have the same mindset as me, and I want him to be a boss. You feel me? Like, no cap. That's what make me happy, bro. Knowing that this little nigga paying attention to his dad, you feel me? Like, if you motivation to your kids gonna wanna do better, your kids gonna be like you. You see what I'm saying? So that's why, like, I show him so much. I show him this stuff. I show him when I'm working. I show him when I'm doing this. I let him listen to me how I talk. You know what I'm saying? I change the way he think about certain things. Cause the other day he said something. He said that boy gay. I don't like that. I said you don't respect it. No, I said you respect it, but you don't rock like that. I told him, I said, don't say you don't like it. Say you don't. You respect it, but you don't rock like that. Like, you don't gotta fool, you know what I'm saying? You don't gotta talk down on it, just say you respect it, but I don't rock like that. And I had to tell the nigga that. So basically teaching him common sense and how to word himself and how to understand. You respect it and you don't rock like that. Tell him, Dad, you gotta tell him.
I was
thinking about the word. That's all you gotta do. Yeah, you got. It's all about how you word it. You see what I'm saying? Yes, sir, man. I got three boys, man.
One more coming out.
One coming right now. We got one on the way. So, he my oldest.
Goddamn. 5 years old.
Then you 5. He my oldest. CJ the second. And my son are coming out now. So this year I'm buying 12, 18 wheelers and I'm putting them in their name. So they gonna have all that money going to them. I don't want to touch that money. I want that shit going. All right, but we said about 5 times, y'all calm down. And I'm gonna lie, nigga. Nigga, goddamn, nigga be going crazy with that beat. But yeah, I just want them to be straight. You see what I'm saying? So now as they growing. I'm gonna be teaching them everything, you feel me? And so now when they get older, they ain't just gonna have no money, you feel me? Cause you can get a dummy money and they'll blow it. And I'm not gonna do that. If my kids don't listen, if they go listen, cause they ain't got no goddamn choice, you see what I'm saying? That's the difference. They ain't got no choice, so they go listen. But if they get older, bro, and they don't wanna pay, like they don't wanna listen to me and understand me and understand how to make money, how to flip money, understand business, they ain't gonna be able to touch that money. Cause I'm not gonna give you money You see what I'm saying? So goddamn just fuck off. You feel me? So yeah. But yeah, yeah, man. For real, like, so that's what I'm doing. So yeah, I'm buying. I want, and the reason why I said 12, 18 wheelers, my goal is to get one every month. I didn't get one last month. I had a lot going on, so I'm finna buy two of them bitches. And man, you know, I'm just gonna get a lot of them, man. You feel me? Like, I got a lot of people who I'm fucking with already. So I'm gonna buy like two or three of them. Buy two, three, five, something like that. Buy five of them, and then the rest of them we're gonna lease them out. So that's why, you know what I'm saying, won't be too big of a headache on me, man. Some shit go wrong, you feel me? They the company know what to do with them. So it's all about being smart, man. You gotta have that business mindset. Yeah, he pick up fast as hell. Tell that nigga pick up fast as hell, like.
Me?
Look, boy, pay attention to your tablet now. Pay you got me your tablet. For sure. Hold on, give me a second, bro. I was on goddamn Coke Live, bro, and that my phone had goddamn was dead, right? That bit, and I stuck the charge in that bitch, it died. For sure. Lame, man. Okay, alright, man. Where the fuck you at, Chris? Where the fuck Chris at? The crew went home.
Whoa, that was bad.
Huh? Yeah, Katie Ball. Man, the fuck you still doing here, bro? The fuck? Alright, I just made $145, man. Already in nine minutes until today, I'd have made $145 already. I just made $145 in 9 minutes, man. Man, no cap, bro. Bro. And when I work at the Hyundai, bro, I was making $6.25 an hour. An hour, bro. I'm gonna go back and find my goddamn boss and tell that nigga something. I was making that shit. I was making $7, so $6.25 an hour. I was getting paid like, let me see. I was working 12 hours a day. Let me tell you how much I was making. I was making $75 a day at regular holiday. No cap. $75 a day. That shit's so crazy, bro. But see. That's how my check was. That's how much I would get paid every 2 weeks, right here. And that's before taxes, bro. That was before taxes. I would get paid $600-something on my mama, dog, and every 2 weeks, bro. No cap. But I was staying in Montgomery. I was there for 6 months. And I knew then, I said something right about this shit. I was working 12 hours a day, every 2 weeks, we got paid. I'm not lying to y'all, I swear to God, everything I love. I walked off the job, bro. I grabbed Carmen, and I walked off the job. And I told him, I said, we're gonna be rich. No cap. I swear. I said we're gonna be rich. I was working the Hyundai plant when they make the little Hyundai car, like the plant. I swear. I was working the Hyundai plant. I think I got my tax paper in there, but I don't think it had nothing on it. To show y'all. But yeah, bro. That's how much was Carmen was making, like, I think Carmen was making like $8 or $9 an hour. And I said, nope. I said, I can't do this shit. Somebody said, what's your first step you took when you left the job? On God, I just made some more money, y'all. Hold on. Let me see how much I just made. Now I'm at $242 in 12 minutes. So 12 minutes until today. Only 12 minutes until the new day, I'm at $242. That's good. Yesterday I made $30,000. I had made $30,000 yesterday. You know what I'm saying? But the first thing I did, bro, when I walked out that job, bro, I had already had a game plan. And that's what people fail to realize. You got to have a game plan before you make moves. Now, I had a game plan. I had already figured everything out. I was already planning in my head. I was like, yeah, I'm going to do this. And I said, if this don't work, I'm going to fall back on this. So what I said, when I walked out the job, I had told Carmen what it was. You know what I'm saying? She didn't know about YouTube. You feel me? So like I was the man that came in with the idea and said, this is what the fuck I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna do it. And I told her to her face, I said, listen, man, I said, just believe in me and just trust me. I promise you, we finna get rich. And I told her, I said, if YouTube don't work, because I told her she gotta quit her job. I didn't want her working on no more. So I said, if YouTube don't work, bro, I said, I swear, I promise you, I will go root with my daddy. I will go back and root with my dad, and you ain't got to do nothing right now. You can just sit at home. I'm going to bring the bag home. Exactly what I told her. I walked out of that job that day. I literally walked out of the job that day. We got home. We had got to the house. And to be honest, y'all, when we did it, we walked out the job, right? We walked out. We got in the car, and we got on the interstate, and we looked at each other. We were like... Damn, we just really walked out the door. Ain't like real. Like, this shit real, nigga. Like, that's how it was. We were looking at each other. We were like, damn, we just really walked out the door. And it was like, it was go time. In my head, it was go time. Like, yeah, it's go time. I gotta go make this shit happen. I'm 18 years old, bro. No cap. I'm 18, bro. I was 19 years old, no cap. And goddamn, 19 years old. We went to the house, picked this goddamn phone up. It wasn't this phone, but it was an iPhone. It was like an iPhone 7, I want to believe, if I'm not mistaken. iPhone 7 or iPhone 8. I went to the house. I picked the motherfucking iPhone up. And I started doing videos. We started doing videos. I went fucking crazy. Look at me in there. He at the restaurant right now. I don't think he's going to lie. Yeah, man. So, you know what I'm saying? So, it's like... It's like I went from making $7 and $6.25 a day. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to say, lie, you started trapping with that phone. Nah, I never in my life sold drugs, none of that shit, man. I never in my life dealt with no drugs, like selling drugs, none of that shit. I never did none of that shit. That wasn't my lane, man. I felt like that was a danger game to play. Selling drugs never even crossed my mind in my life. I always felt like if I want to make money, I'm going to go out and work. I'm not finna sell no drugs. It's too big of a risk, man. You see what I'm saying? It's just too big of a risk. I don't judge nobody that do it, because at the end of the day, I still feel like selling, ain't shit bad about selling drugs. Me, personal opinion, I feel like ain't shit bad about selling drugs. That's just how I feel. The CVS do it. The drug pharmacy do it. The only thing bad about selling drugs, nigga, is that the government can't get taxes off it. That's just how I feel. But what I'm saying, if you do it, your ass going to jail. They're going to try to take you to jail. Just simple as that. You feel me? But, here this motherfucker go, man. I ain't got time for this shit here, bro. I be feeling like people just be picking with me. They be want to bother me. They want to just poke me for no reason. Like, you just poke, just poke me. That's how you feeling. Leave me alone, man. But, nah, shit, goddamn, you know, I just picked up that camera, man. I picked up that camera, bro, and I just went crazy, bro. We went crazy. I had to talk Karma how to do everything. We just went crazy, bro. And then, and so we quit the job in October 2017. So October, November, December, January, February, March. 5 months later, we had made $30,000, no cap. It took 5 months. That's all it took me. 5 months. Hell yeah, boy, it took me 5 months, boy, we did it, boy. And we went through a lot, though, man. That nigga broke in my car in Atlanta. They had stole all our clothes. They stole all car clothes. They stole some of my shit, my belts and shit. They had stole my license. They had stole my fucking passport. They had stole my Ray-Bans, you feel? They stole my game. They had stole all the promo hair that we were doing back then on YouTube. So we had took an ill, man. And, you know, I could have just gave up then, bro, you know. But I'm going to tell y'all, the day that shit happened, I swear to God, I'll never forget. Christmas Eve, bro. I'll never forget, bro. Christmas Eve. We said, you know what? Let's just pack our shit up and just go to Atlanta. Let's just move to Atlanta. Because we was in Atlanta in my bro shit. I was staying in my bro college dorm room. Nobody didn't know. Nobody knew where the fuck we was. I was like keeping that shit on the low, cause I don't nobody know where we're standing at. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, we having it tough right now, but I ain't stunning that shit. And we had said, you know what, they just come up here, man. So I went all the way to Alabama, bro. I drove back to Alabama, 2 hour drive to Alabama. We went and packed up our clothes. I had a surprise for Karma. I had bought like a Michael Kors watch, some shit like that, and all that. And then I had just bought this Xbox One. I'd never forget this shit. I had just met up with this nigga and bought an Xbox One. No cap, bro. Bought the Xbox One, and then we had our shit. We're like, all right, this is it. Let's go. Went back to Atlanta. Soon we got to Atlanta, I went to Atlanta Station. I went to my boy's house. I went to his house. Brand, we had went to Brandon's house. We were like, you know, because we were standing in Murrieta. And goddamn, so I had a bag full of snacks and everything in the car. Yeah, yeah, that shit was funny as hell. I had a bag full of snacks and everything in the car because I had took some snacks with me. So I said, shit, I'm gonna just start right here real quick and let them know we back here. Matter of fact, Chris ass was there. Chris in the line. Let me see Chris in the line. His ass was there. He remember everything. Oh God, Chris ass was he was there. Like all of us there. So went upstairs. Cool. I went upstairs for 20 minutes, bro. I went upstairs for 20 minutes. No cap. 20 minutes, dog. And Carmen went downstairs to go to the car to get the snacks. I think it was something we told her to go get the snacks or something out of the car. Yo, snacks. I said, hey, Carmen, go downstairs and get the snacks out of the car real quick. She went go in first. So mind you, while Carmen went go, somebody down there breaking in my goddamn car. Like, that's crazy. Like, what if she would have went down there while they were breaking in the car, bro? They probably would have shot her or did some crazy shit. See what I'm saying? Unless she was smart, she would have just, I don't know. You just never know how the situation would have went. Gone, man. But goddamn, 20 minutes they broke into my car and stole all my shit. We just quit our job. You feel me? Like, we already ain't making no money, like, as much money as we supposed to be making. You feel me? Goddamn, shit. And I went downstairs, Carmen called. She had called me on FaceTime. Y'all, check this out, right? I wouldn't even hurt or mad. That's just how I knew I was gonna be successful. I just knew I was gonna be rich. That's why I try to tell y'all. Kanye West said that shit. Kanye West said, bro, I just felt like I could do anything I want. It started with your mindset, bro. Like, you put in your mind, I can do whatever I want to do. I just knew I was gonna be rich. I walked down that motherfucking way. I seen my shit. I seen my windows. They ain't busted. It really shocked me because I was like, these niggas is some roguish ass motherfuckers. These niggas that broke into my car, bro, and didn't even break the window. What they did was they had fucked around and did something in the door handle. On the end of the door handle, they did some shit. I don't know what the fuck they did. They did some crazy shit. And I guess the windows just came down. And they went in there and stole everything. They had got the watch, my wallet. They had went spend them over and spent $100 at Church of Chicken. And I had to call my car. So I'm looking at the car. We call the police to do the damn report. And I'm down that bitch and smiling. I'm smiling. I'm just laughing. I'm like, man, this shit crazy. I said, bro, we just went and got all our shit. They just came and broke into my car. More people probably would have been mad, screaming at the room, ready to fight everybody. You know what I'm saying? I had a smile on my face, dog. Nigga just broke into my car, stole all my shit. I had a smile on my face. No cap. I swear to God. Get what I did. All right. It's time to go hard now. It's time for me to put that work in. To this day, I think about that shit sometimes. Like, man, I wonder who broke into my car, man. I want to appreciate you, man. You gave me a little motivation. You don't even know. Somebody said the video's still on the main channel. Yeah, the video's still up. They can go to my main channel and watch the whole video. The video's still up when that shit happened. I blocked the whole shit. And yeah, bro. Fuck that shit, man. I feel damn good, bro. I feel damn good, man. Like, real talk. I feel damn good, bro. And that happened in December. So in January, then when we had went to Miami for the first time. First time going to Miami, I had drove my Kia down there. Then when I seen that Ford truck. That's when I seen that Ford truck. That big ass Ford truck. And then when I knew I wanted a truck, I said, I'm gonna get me a truck. I said, I'm gonna get me a motherfucking truck. I don't care what nobody say, I'm gonna get me a truck. I'll run. I seen that big ass motherfucker come behind me. I seen them damn squirrel lights. The lights I got, I seen them lights. That bitch was so motherfucking big. I was starstruck. I said, oh shit. I said, that bitch clean. I told Carl, I said, man, I gotta get me one of those. I was like, that bitch hard, boy. Oh God. Got that. Fuck they talking about. Shit, nigga, come on, man. You'll be happy too. You goddamn come from making goddamn $6.25 and you chase your dream. You said you gonna be rich and that shit really happened. You really went out and did that shit. That shit feel damn good, man. I'm trying to tell y'all, bro. That shit feel damn good, my nigga. Like, yeah, niggas, you know. Yeah, try to tell people, man, you can do what the fuck you want to do, for real. Y'all be acting like y'all scared to go out chase y'all dream, like that shit will bite you or some shit. I want my dream to bite me hard, shit, fuck you talking about. It ain't that way they gonna take. For real. He said, man, listen. Keep going, what up, Nick? But yeah, I just, you know what I'm saying, I be trying to tell y'all, man. Sometimes the enemy be your biggest push. No, that's some real shit though. That's some real shit. Bro, why did motherfucker keep putting his ear, bro? Hey, listen, that's some real shit though. I swear to God, like, and people don't understand, man, why I love my haters, bro. I love my supporters at the end of the day because my supporters support me and my supporters give me a reason to push out motivation to help people. But I love my haters, man. It's like every time a motherfucker come hate on me, it's like, all right, I'm finna shit even harder. So anything you say about me, I'm finna go even harder. You say I can't do this, I'm finna go do it. I'm finna make sure I do it now. So people don't understand, your haters is what keep you going, bro. They make you work harder. Cause now you like, you know what, I'm finna go do this shit now. A nigga threw $300,000 in my face, cuz. And say he made that shit in 1 month. I just made $219,000 in 1 day. Come on. Tell me how the fuck that shit ain't pushed me. Shit, when he showed me he made $300,000 in 1 month, I know it's possible now. So now I gotta goddamn get this shit going. I done made $219,000 in 1 day. You can't tell me shit, bro. Ain't no way. Ain't no fucking way, boy. For real. I'm just keeping in the band, you feel me? So I tell all y'all this shit, especially my young people. I tell y'all the time, man, get y'all credit right, bro. Get your credit right now. For all y'all that young out here, y'all older people too, though. If all my older people, man, get your credit. Y'all niggas should know better, bro. Y'all niggas should know to get y'all credit right. But for real. For real. For all my young people, get your credit right, bro. I don't fuck with anybody telling y'all. Don't listen. If a motherfucker tell you, fuck that. Listen to me. Get your credit right. You feel what I'm saying? And chase your dreams, bro. And go out and get whatever the fuck you want. I swear to God. If you listen to me, bro, and you learn knowledge, bro, I'm telling y'all, y'all will go a long ways in life, bro. Just listen to me, bro. I'm from Alabama. I tell y'all, where, I want to show y'all something. I want to show all y'all something real quick. I want to show y'all my hometown. Let me show y'all my hometown real quick. We'll go to Google Maps. I want to show y'all this shit. This shit really should just be motivation to y'all, bro. Union Springs, Alabama. This is where I grew up at, bro. This area, this my whole, I grew up here my whole life. No cap until I moved. This is where I grew up my whole life, bro. I just want to show y'all something real quick, bro. No cap. Put that bitch on goddamn, hey, can you do the, what, Fred will do this. Hey, look, man, this is my hometown, bro. Right here, this is right here, this little circle right here. This is my city, bro. No cap, this is where I'm from. Union Springs, Alabama, bro. Put that motherfucking, let me see. Yep. Satellite. Over there. Listen, bro, this is my home. Bro, listen, y'all. We only got 4 traffic lights, bro. It ain't no excuse. Where you from don't determine where the fuck you can go, bro. You feel what I'm saying? Somebody's gotta talk to him. Let me go ahead and block that whole ass nigga. Block that nigga CB, whatever. Put that nigga in the CB, CTB. All right, bro. He gone now. Got rid of that nigga ass. But, like, I can pull up, bro. I can pull up. Listen, this bitch so small. Hey, Boosin, our hometown so small, bro. I can dead ass pull up everywhere I stay in right now, just on this map right here, right now. Why this shit? Carter Freedom Home right here. I'm gonna show y'all my sister died at. Hold on, let me see. I'm gonna show y'all my sister died at. My sister died right here. It was Wayne Form. All right, here my sister died right here. Right there. There my sister died at. They go to the house right here. My sister died right in this room right here. This is where my sister died at, for the people that don't know. In that room right there in this apartment. Right there. That's just the exact room my sister died, bro. No cap. Goddamn, let me zoom out. Nigga, I used to listen. For the people that don't know me, bro. I was staying right here in high school. I was staying right here, right? Because this is my auntie house. So my sister died because the house caught on fire. The apartment had caught on fire right there. So when I was in high school, which was not too long ago, 16, 17 and shit, I was staying right here, bro. Nigga, I used to walk to my school. I used to walk from right here. How you zoom out right here? Let me show y'all. I used to walk to my school. But I used to walk from right here to the apartments, bro. Listen, I used to walk. No cap. All the way down here. Let me go down.
I believe you see your love.
Wait a minute, right here, okay, look. So, I used to walk all the way to my school right here, which is right here. There's my high school right here, which y'all see. That's my high school, Bullitt County High School. My school's small as shit. But I used to walk all the way from up here to, from these apartments. From right here, I used to walk right there. All right, cool. So, yeah, goddamn, that's my high school. It was my middle school right there. Sahali Middle School, that's my middle school. When I was in middle school, I stayed right here. Michelle, where I stayed in when I was in middle school. My house right there. I stayed right here. That's where I stayed at. Alright, cool. Now, so this is the city. This is how small my little city is. Real, real small town. Like, to be so small, I used to ride my bike. I used to ride my bike everywhere. That's why I used to stay right here also. I used to stay right here when I was in high school. When I first got in high school, before I had stopped staying, I was staying with my own mama. So we were staying. What the hell down trail is it? Oh, right here. No cap. They go my old house right here, and it's trailer park right here. See, this is a trailer park called Gibson Circle. I can pull up some shit and show y'all the history that when I used to stay here. This is where you know what I'm saying. A lot, like, I was in high school. We stayed here for a while, for a few years. And I used to, ride my bicycle through the pathway right here. I used to go through this pathway, right? It's a church right there. A house right there. Go through that pathway. All the way right here, actually. Come through your way. And I used to ride my bike to the city. I used to get around everywhere. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah, we had the last house. And look, my cousin stayed right here. And remember I told y'all my mama had kicked me out the house one time. And I had to walk no shoes on. Yeah, I was staying right here. And I hit my cousin right here. And I went to my cousin's house. My cousin got mad. You know what I'm saying? Now, let me show out my dad. So now, show out the country. So they call it Aberfoyle, right? This is Aberfoyle. This is the country. So that's the city. You go out here, you go to the country. So that's where I grew up at, in the country. So it's the city. It ain't part at all. It's the country. So, oh, shit. Go back. So this is where I grew up in right here. I grew up right here also in the country. My dad. Let me show y'all. Show my dad a shot real quick. Hold up. For the people that don't know, check this out, right? Boom, right here. Damn, look, y'all. Look at this shit, bro. It's showing my dad was building his shop. Damn, this shit crazy. Hold on, let me show you this shit. Damn, this some good ass shit. This dope as fuck. By the fact, it look like we were down there wrecking on that motherfucker. Don't care. Let me see if I zoom in. Oh, God. Then my dad, bro, I'm going to laugh my ass off, bro. I swear to God, bro. Bro, that look like my... Bro, hold up, bro. Ain't no way. Ain't no fucking way, bro. So look, this is the shop that I be in. Y'all see me on my daddy when I go to my blogs, my daddy's shop. This is the shop. We were building that bitch. My daddy built his own shop. And he got an old shop. The old shop was right across the street. So I grew up in this trailer right here also. This is a trailer I grew up in. As you guys can see, we got cars. They got an old shop right there. If y'all go back and watch the documentary, I walked over there and I showed y'all. I said, this was an old shop used to be at. As y'all can see, they got a car in the backyard in the junkyard right here. This shit crazy as fuck, bro. So, yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, my daddy built, he built that shop himself. That was his first shop. That was the first shop my daddy had right there. He built it himself. And goddamn, this is where we were standing right here. And then my granddad was standing across the street, actually. And then with my granddad, they had swap. They don't know what the hell they did. Swap house or something. And then we stayed. Now my daddy was standing right here in this house. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, bro. No cap. Like, they where I'm from, man. This shit crazy as fuck. That shit dope, though. That's some dope ass shit. So, yeah. But, yeah, bro. Like, that just. And then, yep. Yep. That's dope as shit. That's my city, bro. And then my grandma, Alabama. So let me show you so people can understand what I was trying to tell them. So this is the country, right? So look, that's where I'm from, the country. This is going to my grandma, Alabama, right here. So this is the city. So we have to go way to my grandma, Alabama, to go to Walmart, you know what I'm saying? That just, like, to go to where everything get, basically. Like, we're going to go grocery shopping, for real, Walmart. All the major stores and shit. This is where I was born. I was born in my grandma. But I wasn't raised with my grandma. See what I'm saying? So, boom. Yeah, man. So, it's really like a 35 to 45 minute drive from New Orleans Rain to Montgomery, Alabama. So, this should show y'all the difference. So, here in Houston, Texas, it takes 35 minutes, bro, just to go to the mall, and which ain't far at all. It's considered down the road, 35 minutes to go to the mall. 35 minutes took you through goddamn one city, two city, three city, four city. Took you through four city where we at, boy. When you go to goddamn where I'm from, nigga, 35 minutes gonna take you through four cities, dog. No cap. Real shit. Take you through four cities just to get to the main city. Oh, God. That shit, wow. So it's like I just, you know what I'm saying? I just want to show people, bro. I just want to motivate y'all. I don't know how much goddamn motivation gonna take. If that ain't enough, cuz. I don't know what to tell you, my nigga. That where I'm from, right there. And I had a goal in my head, and I said that I'm going to achieve it. I don't give a fuck who don't like it. I'm going to achieve it. And I changed my dream, bro. I mean, made that shit happen. By any means necessary, bro. That's where I'm from, my nigga. New Orleans Springs, fucking Alabama, dog. Oh, shit. Now I'm in goddamn. What the fuck is that? Three notch. I live in the area like that, but in Illinois. Yeah, bro, it just...
That's what happened?
Yup, that's what happened, bro. That what happened, man. For real. Daddy had to shut up.
I don't like that. I just like to stay with family.
Nigga used to walk three miles. Used to walk 3 miles to high school. Shit crazy. Yeah, but I used to walk to school, bro. That was that time I told y'all. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm gonna go back to it. I don't like telling the story because I always cry like a little bitch. Ain't no bitch though, nigga. it just how I felt back then. That shit hurt me back then, though. I ain't gonna lie. So when I was in high school, right, it was the first day of school, and it was the other dude in high school that used to root my daddy. And back then, I really just feel like he was trying to take my spot. You know what I'm saying? You know somebody root with your dad or some shit like that, and you feel like somebody taking your spot with you and your dad relationship with a bun. So. He was a little older than me or whatever, but I knew how to drive and everything. My dad knew this. And so it was the first day of school. My dad told me he was going to let me drive the Escalade to school. He had rims on that motherfucker. Had some 28s on that bitch and all that shit, right? And he had told me he was going to let me drive the car to school. And I was like, all right, cool. You know, he always lied to me. My dad stayed lying. That motherfucker lied like a motherfucker. Now, he'll lie. All right, for real. All right, and goddamn. So this is where I was staying. My auntie's, I told you, in apartments, right? Oh, there you go. All right, give me a sec. That motherfucker. But all right, anyway, so yeah. So I was staying right here. My dad told me he was gonna let me goddamn drive the car. So let me see if you can hear me real quick. Sometimes I feel like that though, my mama. My mama always been a liar. Hey, somebody said, I thought that my mama always been a liar. Ain't no fucking way, bro. No, God, my dad used to lie like a motherfucker. Though. I swear to God, that nigga, I'll call that nigga right now here, and I'll tell y'all. I said, that nigga done a lot too goddamn much. So, all right, cool. So, I was waiting on him to call me back. He never called me back. So, I was like, fuck it. I'm gonna just start walking to school. So, I started walking to school. Walked down the road. I'm walking to school. I crossed the street. I remember like it was yesterday. I swear to God, I was right here. Hold up. Give me that, boy. I was right here, bro. I was right here on the sidewalk, right here walking. Ash the road, right here. I was right here. I was walking, dog. And I seen my dad's truck pass by me, nigga. And so, it passed right by me. I just asked my dad told me to let me drive the truck to school. You gotta think about it, bro. I'm in high school. Niggas just wanna go to school, shine. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas wanna just go to school. Like, come on, man. If I know for a fact I got hard ass cars, bro, and my son old enough to drive one of my cars, bro, I'm gonna let my son drive my car to school. You feel what I'm saying? Cause I knew how I felt when I was young. You feel me? So, I let this, so, goddamn. I'm walking to school with my nigga. My dad a truck pad by me, bro. So I'm like, damn, what the fuck? So I remember calling him, he answered the phone. So, all right, cool. I take my little ugly ass all the way to school. I walk all the way to school. I walk all the way down here. This is long walk right here. I walk all the way down here. I walk all the way down here. I'm walking to school. So I'm walking to school. It's on my school. So I get to the school, right? No cap. I never forget this shit. I get to my school. So on the first day of school, everybody that drive always be right here in the parking lot. You know what I'm saying? Everybody be right here in the parking lot because, you know, everybody's showing out and shit like that right there. I came right here. I was walking right here on the side of the school, right? And I hit the gate right here. It's a gate right here where I can see the whole, like, the parking lot. I see my dad.